Just after 5:04, the long-awaited launch window of Artemis I is just 2 days away, and News 19 is continuing to recognize some of the companies with Huntsville ties that designed and built the Space Launch System rocket. News 19 Samson Tamajani shows us the company behind the rocket's firepower.
A company with a storied past helping astronauts lift off into space now powers the SLS rocket we'll see Monday. The motors and engines that are provided by Aerojet Rocketdyne are designed right here in Huntsville.
So many people in the community are working on different parts of the rocket, so it feels like one big group project your whole life of completing this, and like Monday it's coming to fruition, so that's really cool.
They've gone before.
Fine. All three engines up and burning.
These four engines have been flight tested and actually been on flight supporting the space shuttle. So they used to be called space shuttle main engines. And for the first four Artemis flights, all of those engines, so 16 RS-25 engines, are coming from the space shuttle program.
This time, Aerojet Rocketdyne is going beyond. With familiar engines made smarter with the help of rocket scientists like Morgan County native Allison Varner, who tests the RS-25 software.
We're going to continue to update software, test it out in our lab, improve the engine design, improve all designs that we can, and continuing to support those missions.
You could say the Varner name is also familiar to Huntsville's lunar legacy.
My grandpa worked on the Saturn V. He was a systems engineer, I believe, and came down to Huntsville and worked with Dr. von Braun on the Saturn V. So that's very, very cool to think that we're working on similar things. You know, when I'm going to watch the launch on Monday, thinking about him seeing, you know, that launch go to the moon and that he worked on that, and that we're just continuing in that legacy is really cool.
While these engines were designed in Huntsville, Ryan Wirtz helped build and perfect another crucial SLS part at Aerojet Rocketdyne's North Huntsville complex.
Our team worked primarily on the jettison motor on the launch abort stack on the Orion capsule. So at the very tippy, the pointy end of the rocket, that is there in the event of an emergency. It'll pull the capsule away from the rest of the rocket to keep the crew safe.
Both these bright young minds say they're ready for their work to shoot for the moon.
Everyone, regardless of what you're studying, can help support this mission if that's what you want to do. So it's really cool to see.
There's a lot of moving parts that have to work together successfully to make it happen. But it's super exciting, you know, pushing the boundaries of you know, our knowledge of space and of the cosmos.
In Huntsville, Samson Tamajani, News 19.
And just a reminder, News 19 this morning will bring you live coverage of the first launch window of Artemis 1. Our live coverage starts Monday morning at 5 o'clock.